Morning is managing diabetes, and we're fortunate to have again with us during the second segment to talk about some of the issues associated with diabetes, Ms. Consuela Green. And Ms. Green is a health worker at Matthew Walker Comprehensive Health Center. And of course, Ms. Green, we might have confused Meharry and Matthew Walker, right. But I think it's primarily because so many people understand who Matthew Walker was and his connection with Meharry Medical College.
Definitely, and we've been around over 30 years. We serve not only the underserved, but we also serve the uninsured populations as well as those who are able to pay for their services. So yeah, we've been around, offer medical and dental services for years.
Very good. And so it's a very, very significant institution within the African American community in Nashville, even though you have only recently moved into that very spacious.
You know, I have to plug that in.
Do that.
We just moved into our new facility. It's a state-of-the-art facility. It's at 1035 14th Avenue North. It's on a corner of Jefferson Street, 14th Avenue North. So definitely, if you don't have a home, a medical home, a dental medical home, you can contact us at 327-9400, and we will be more than happy to serve you.
You know, Mr. Green, when we talk about managing diabetes, and let's sort of move it back into that direction, let's talk about the disease itself.
Okay.
Why don't you give our audience as much information as you care to give in terms of just diabetes?
Okay. Well, one of the things that I mentioned before we went on the break was that diabetes is a disease that affects the entire body. It affects not only the pancreas, because that's where the inability to produce insulin comes in at, but also when you have high levels of blood sugar within your body, then it starts to affect other organs, such as your kidneys, your eyes, your circulation. And so you have a lot of limbs being amputated. You have a lot of an increased number of people going blind because of diabetes. Kidney dialysis. You have a lot of people who are on kidney dialysis. And the interesting thing about this disease is it doesn't just happen. It's not contracted overnight like HIV and AIDS. But this is something that has been going on for years within your body. It may have been lying dormant. You may have been experiencing symptoms, and I'm going to talk about that in just a minute. But that could have been going on for years, and you not even know that you had this disease. And what happens is when we do go to the doctor, when we do go to the physician, it's when we have the complication. And so now you're experiencing a blurry vision, and now you're experiencing kidney failure, renal failure, or now you have a black toe, and now they're gonna have to amputate it. And so we want to be a generation that just not responds or reacts to the complication, but we respond when our body tells us, because we know our bodies, and we know when our bodies are telling us that something is going on. And so immediately when we find that out, we wanna make sure we do something about it. Now, as far as some of the symptoms, you know, let me back up. There are like two types, type 1 and type 2. Type 1 diabetes is mostly those individuals who do not make any insulin in their body. And so these individuals, their treatment will be their doctor will give them insulin to help them. You find this normally within children. We call it juvenile diabetes. And then there's type 2 diabetes, which is the most common form. It's found mostly in African Americans and minority groups. Type 2 diabetes is an adult onset diabetes. And so you experience this, you make either no or little insulin within your body. With type 2, you can treat it several ways, either with a pill or through your diet and exercise, and that definitely will have to come from the physician. And also you can treat it with insulin. And so you have three different types of treatment scenarios. And then there's gestational diabetes. And gestational diabetes is normally in people, of course, who are pregnant, people who've had babies over 9 pounds and they have had high blood sugar in their blood. While they were pregnant. Normally when they are through delivering the baby, then the gestational diabetes has gone away. You don't see it anymore. But statistics have told us that later on in years, as they begin to grow and everything, maybe about 50% of these individuals will develop diabetes over time. So you're looking at three types. Now some of the symptoms to these diseases are as follows. You have Now, increased blurry vision, you have an increase in thirst, you have frequent urination, you have a numbness and tingling of feet, you have a healing sores that won't heal, well, cuts and bruises that won't heal. So, you know, we like to get herbal remedies and get all these over-the-counter drug medications to try and apply it on it. And if it doesn't work, we need to make sure we go to the physician. But those are just some of the symptoms. If you find yourself experiencing some of those symptoms, go see your doctor, because your doctor will be able to evaluate you by doing several tests, either a urine test to check for ketones, or either a blood test, fasting or non-fasting, just to check to see if you have a diabetes. If you are a person who has a family member that has diabetes, I would definitely say you need to get the test. All the time, the physicians do not just do the test, but sometimes, you know, you have to be the empowering person in position and say, you know what, doctor, I need you to check me for diabetes. And once you do that, and he checks you, then you can find out whether or not you are living with it, or because if you have a family member that is at risk or who has diabetes, then you are more likely to be at risk, and so your chances of developing diabetes over time has increased definitely.
Would you say, Ms. Green, then, that because this family member has this disease, that perhaps the eating habits or the non-exercise habits and et cetera of that person who has the disease might also be one of your problems? Is that a suggestion?
You know what? With diabetes, only about 20% of individuals develop diabetes through genetically.
Good.
80%, though, of those individuals develop it through and normally it's type 2 diabetes, and they develop it through behavior. So you're saying, what we're saying is your lack of exercise and your diet, not eating correctly, you not doing what you're supposed to do from the onset could lead to increased risk factor. But yes, definitely, because you have a family member, a sibling, a parent that has it, you are more likely to be at risk. Now, it does not mean that you have to get it, that you have to develop it, because sometimes when you find out this information, and that's why it's so important to have us on, because you can educate and re-educate people, but until they apply it to their lives, then it doesn't make a difference.
Very good. And so, Ms. Green, we're getting ready for the second commercial break here, after which we'll come back and we'll give you an opportunity to talk about some additional things.
Okay.
But what we're concerned about here, I think you've indicated that there are a large number of people who do have diabetes.
Definitely.
But yet they might not know that they have diabetes, and it can only make it worse for them rather than make it better. It's not going to get any better. It generally gets worse. Is that what we're saying?
We are saying that over 18 million people have.
And of course, we'll talk about that when we come back after the second commercial break. We're talking to Ms. Consuela.